Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Every Django project should have a secret key. By default, when we create a Django project, a Django project secret key is generated for us automatically. But typically, we want to then make sure that we add our own secret key. Now, a secret key isn't something that we want the public to access. And if they did, potentially it causes a security risk to our application. The Django secret key is used to provide cryptographic signing. Now, it's a little bit of outer scope of this project at this point, and as and when we need to discuss it throughout the project, we will do. But what we need to understand, it's important that we generate a secret key and we keep it secure. So back in our project here, you can see that when we created a new project, this is in our base file, you can see that this secret key is generated, and we're even told by Django. Django adds this string here, Django insecure, suggesting that this is an insecure secret key. Now, the minimum length of this key is one character, so you can go ahead and use that as a secret key if you like, but that's not a very good secret key, and ideally we want to make it nice and lengthy. Now, we can go ahead and just type in something random if we like, not a problem at all, and that can be pretty limitless. But there are tools that are available, and the tools that Django utilizes, which really does come from the Python built-in tools, a tool which enables us to generate a secret key. So we will learn in the next tutorials how to actually start to think about securing the secret key, but let's just go ahead and create a new secret key first. Right, so for this, we can access the Python shell. So through manage.py, we access a Python shell, which is kind of wrapped around by manage.py to give us access to Django tools. So let's open up a Python shell, interactive shell here. So from here, you can then go ahead and now import some of the tools. Now, where is this coming from? In your browser, I've just typed in, or in my browser, not your browser. In my browser, I've typed in Django GitHub. So this is going to take me to the source for Django. So inside of here, we're looking for Django, the folder Django. And inside of here, we're looking for core. And then inside of here, we're looking for management. And then utilities. And inside of here, we're going to find get random secret key. So it's going to be a function that's going to provide us a way of generating a random key. So if we can't find it, let's just type it in. So get underscore random, there we go, secret key. So on line 79. So you can see here what's happening. It's going to return a 50 character random string usable as a secret key. And it defines the characters that can be used. And down here, you can see it's limiting to 50. Now, if you're interested, you can follow along. If I select get random secret key, you can see that in actual fact, this is coming from the Django utils crypto. So you can go back one and have a look at that. And then eventually you'll find that's probably connected to some of the base Python built-in tools that kind of is utilized to build these types of strings. But I guess that's irrelevant for us now. Let's go ahead now and use the get random secret key to generate a random key. So we just need to remember where we found them. So from Django, inside of a Django core management.utils, let's go ahead and import the get random secret key. Okay, and I press enter. So I've now imported that in, so I can now go ahead and use it. So let's go ahead and print a new secret key. So get random secret key. Okay, and there we go. So we now have a secret key, so I'll just go ahead and utilize that. Of course, if you don't like that, you can just press up and press enter again and create a new one. So let's go back and add that now into our secret key. If you haven't already found it, in each section of the course, you will find a commands file. And inside of that should be a list of all the commands that we utilize within each section of the course. And hopefully that will help you if you have forgotten to save you a little bit of time, maybe if you're having to rewind or look for a particular place where I used a command. All the commands that I use will be printed here. Now, they aren't necessarily going to be labeled, but you will find them somewhere in the file called commands.md, and then that is found in each section of the course or where the resources are placed in the course. So something that, some added information, what we may have is a situation where we would like to, just make us close all this, we would want to use a different secret key locally to maybe production. So it might be that we actually think about removing the secret key here and placing it in local and in production and use different secret keys for different environments. But as I alluded to, the first thing that we should consider is securing the secret key. And that's what we're going to do next, discuss a little bit about how to implement utilizing environment variables and then essentially hiding the secret key away from the application within the operating system and making it accessible by the application, and thus in that process, making it a little bit more secure and harder to access should anyone try to.